All right, so this is Dora Smith, and I'm here with Martin Stucki from Marenco Swiss Helicopter, who presented a little bit earlier. And for those that weren't there, can you share a little bit about the title of your presentation was Clean Sheet, from a clean sheet to a finished helicopter. Why did you guys start with a clean sheet? Tell me a little bit about your business and market.
I think it was a very important point about our project, because we had the advantage that we did not have some history, we did not have the need to look on a model that is always existing, on molds that there exist, so we could start on a clean sheet, so we could really put in the best ideas available and all the customer requests into one product, and that's why it's an important point, and it allowed us to make something that is not completely new. Helicopters are available since 100 years, but it's new from the combination of all these ideas in one product.
And it sounds like maybe you somewhat defined or serving a niche market because of that, some kind of more unique needs in the industry?
You mean the needs for this product?
Yeah, who are your end customers that you were describing?
I mean,
basically
it's operators who operate the helicopter then in the multi-role configurations. That means they do not only use it for one role, they use it for many roles at the same day, for example. And I think over 90% of the customers will be operators, and then we have some private operators maybe, but mainly.
Yeah, I actually had I thought that was interesting. At the end of your presentation, you were talking about that one event you went to that then sold out really your production for the, that was it the first year? You had so much interest in it?
Yes, it was extremely nice for us, because we were also a little bit skeptical how will the market react. Mm-hmm. And we have been to the Heli exhibition in Orlando. It's the largest only helicopter exhibition worldwide, and the feedback from customers, but also the feedback from the manufacturer, were extremely positive. We could sign 12 letters of intent since then, so the first year of production is sold out. So that's very nice, because it proved we are on the right way.
Right. Now you talked a little bit about innovation cycles, these long innovation cycles of 30 plus years. We talk about innovation, but normally people refer to it as product life cycle. Tell me why you call it innovation cycle, and what do you think is important to your business with it?
It's a little bit because the important thing, it's maybe this product, the youngest one in our market, is from 1976, and it was updated 2 times, but it was updated exactly on the same base, so they could not start with a clean sheet of paper. Mm-hmm. They had to make all the compromises, and so it was very hard to get real new innovation in it. You can make a better performance, for example, but you cannot change something that would change the possibility of the helicopter, because you stick on the old concept. And I think the special thing in aerospace anyway, and especially in this segment of the helicopter market, is that this cycle is extremely long. So it's over 30 years, because the competition is then more towards 40 years or even older.
Okay. Yeah, I think you said it's a person with the newest design that's going to win in this market, so you got to constantly...
Yes, basically it's actually true that the newest design are sold the best, and I think with a really new design it becomes a winner.
You also talked a little bit about your CAX tools, and you talked a little bit about NX and then some other applications you used. You referred to the NX assembly capabilities as really being best in class. Tell me why you feel that way. What do you really take advantage of within the NX tool?
Yes, I think basically when you look on CAD tools, they are becoming more and more close to each other, because everybody now can model 3D, that's common. I think one large differentiator is really the ability to handle large assemblies, and NX was always strong in that, and they are still strong. And for us it was an extremely important point, because we did not want to have another format or something different for the digital mockup. We wanted to have it directly in the CAD, And in this respect, we think NX is best in class, and that's why we decided for NX.
And what about any other tools that are really important, either from a CAE or even a CAM standpoint, or really important to helicopter design?
I think for us, in some aspects, what we do in-house, we do a lot of manufacturing with NX directly from our data, but also sometimes also from other CAD systems we take over. And then for the helicopter project, important was the ability to do especially the calculation, finite element calculation or motion simulation that the engineer is doing close to his work directly in one tool, so that you do not have to translate the data and lose time with translation or lose the associativity when you change something, because you want to make a lot of loops in your development in very short time and look out for the best product you can get.
So next time I'm in Switzerland and in Zurich, I can come see one of these helicopters live and in person.
Yes, for sure.
Okay.
That's possible.